When you first started doing heavy pulls, you were using the double overhand grip. That is, until the bar slipped out of your hand. And at that point, you thought to yourself, I'm going to move on to the mixed grip, which you did. Now, was this the right move? Let's find out. So first of all, the reason why guys get away from double overhand is because the forearms become a limiting factor here, because your grip will never be as strong as your back and biceps. The bar starts rolling in your hands and you can't really lift that heavy. So when you use a mixed grip, basically the bar prevents from rolling in a sense, because you got the underhand and you got the over, and it's kind of doing this little effect right here, which keeps it in a nice little position, right? So it makes you more stable, in other words. But there are some problems with a mixed grip. The first issue being the fact that you're at a greater risk of tearing your bicep. Now, I know this is not anything new. You've heard this before, but it's the God honest truth. Drug-free or not, if you are using a mixed grip on deadlifts, you are at a greater risk of tearing your bicep, especially if the program is very intense. If you're running anything like a Bulgarian training system, where you're going to be doing heavy maxes every single day or close to your max, you're at a greater risk. If you're doing a very intense program where you're working with high percentages very frequently, you're at a greater risk. If you're working on a peaking system, you know, you're at a greater risk. That's why a lot of guys, powerlifters in particular, tear their biceps right before meet. This is very common, okay? And if you're on drugs, the chances skyrocket even more, because the tendon strength will not catch up to the muscle strength, because the drugs will make your muscles blow up, and then the tendon is going to be lagging a little bit, and then boom, you snap your shit up. Then also with drugs, you can handle more volume, right? So you're going to be putting more stress on the bicep tendon itself. So you are at a greater risk of tearing your bicep, no questions asked. Whether you're keeping your arm straight or not, that's a lot of stress on the tendons, okay? The fact of the matter is that your bicep is not that strong of a muscle group. It's not supposed to support that much weight. So if you're an elite puller, like, the stronger you get, the greater the chance of tearing your bicep becomes, regardless if you're using correct form and all those other factors, regardless if you're on drugs or not. I know tons of drug-free powerlifters that tore their bicep and now they're out of the game. So that is a major risk to consider. The second problem, which is probably the worst, is the fact that you will, without a doubt, develop muscular imbalances, okay? Because one arm is going to be supinated and the other is overhand, which causes your body to do a little bit of a twisting effect, and one of your sides will become overdeveloped. In particular, the traps, upper back, obliques, and hips will become shifted, right? Next thing you know, when you go do rows, you got a muscular imbalance. Next thing you know, when you go do bench press, one bar, like when you're lowering the bar, it's a bit uneven, right? Next thing you know, you start getting shoulder pain when you bench. Next thing you know, you start getting snapped up in places you never imagined because of one little imbalance. If you saw my video that I made a while back called Got Uneven Traps, here's the fix. I identify a lot of those causes and I give you some little solutions around it, but I can assure you that doing mixed grip puts you at a far greater risk of developing these muscular imbalances. So although it might not affect your deadlift performance directly, it'll affect you in other ways, because now you got one side of your body that's overdeveloped. Now, some people are going to say, oh, well, just switch the side, switch the grip. But you see, people don't actually do that in the real world. You just stick to your standard hand, your standard under, your standard over, and you keep doing that over and over again. And you know what? Even if you do switch the grip, if you have a muscular imbalance, that's not going to correct it, okay? The only way you can simply get rid of it is by attacking it with special exercises, special mobility drills, and switching to double over. But the problem with double over is that your grip is going to be a limiting factor. So what is the next best solution next to the mixed grip? Well, it's the hook grip. Hook grip involves this, you know? You dig your thumb under the bar, you just grab onto it. A lot of weightlifters do this, especially for cleans, you know? A lot of powerlifters compete in the deadlift using the hook grip. And this pretty much gets rid of all the negatives. However, even the hook grip has its limitations. Number one, it hurts like hell. Two, I don't believe it's safe or sustainable in the long run. Like, can you really tell me that holding over 500 pounds in your thumb is a good idea? I just don't see the benefit in doing that. Then thirdly, you can't use the hook grip on other stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't do shrugs with a hook grip. It's going to destroy your thumbs because the momentum on the way down. You can't row with a hook grip. There's a lot of exercises that you can't do with a hook grip. And even at that, like, it's not even developing your grip that effectively. It's just putting a lot of fucking strain on your thumbs, you know? So yeah, you're getting around the problem of, the muscular imbalances and tearing your bicep, but at what cost? Killing your thumbs and still not being optimal? That's another point right there. You can't lift as heavy with that freaking grip, okay? Because the pain is so unbearable and you are going to be limited by things like your finger length and just the nature of the hook grip itself. It's not an effective position for lifting maximum amounts of weight. So then what can we do? Well, first of all, if you are a competitive powerlifter or you do weightlifting, yes, consider the hook grip because you're kind of going to have to if you're not using the mix. But in the event that you are a recreational lifter, which I assume most of you are, there's a better solution, which is double overhand with straps. Oh, yes. You see, this eliminates all the problems that we previously talked about. You know, your double overhands, you're not going to develop any muscular imbalances. The risk of tearing your bicep is greatly, greatly, greatly diminished. It's probably never going to happen. And you get maximum comfort, maximum security, maximum benefits in terms of weight lifted. Because with straps, you can either single loop it, right? Double loop or triple loop, okay? So you have three different levels here, depending on the length of it, that will allow you to lift very heavy weights. So you don't even have to go all the way with the straps. You can just do like one loop and boom, you're good. That's even better than a hook grip. You can do double loop, you can go triple loop. The point is, with straps, your grip will never, ever, ever be a limiting problem ever again, right? The shitty bars that you use at your gym, the ones that roll, will never be a problem. It will allow for better recovery in the hands, which means you can put more volume into your back training and other things like that. And on top of that, like, you can just do your direct grip work right after. Because let's be honest here, like, mixed grip deadlifts and hook grip deadlifts are not even optimal for the grip in the first place. If it was, all the powerlifters in the world would be the best at grip sport, but usually they suck ass. Grip sport is the official sport for testing your grip, all right? Arm wrestling, that's another form of forearm strength, but I can assure you that powerlifting training or deadlift training is not the most optimal way of developing your grip strength. Please watch my video, The Ultimate Grip Strength Guide, and I give you principles on how to improve that. But you see, you should consider double overhand with straps. Number one, they're cheap as fuck. They're like $15. It can last you a lifetime for the most part, or maybe not a lifetime, but you know, some years, you know, it does not slip out of your hands. It's comfortable. It's the maximum weight. What more do you want? Straps are truly phenomenal. It's going to revolutionize your training. And like I said, it takes 5 to 10 minutes to train your grip. That's it. If you do 5 sets of 60 on your farmer walks with a minute rest intervals in between, that's 10 minutes and you're done. And that's a hard workout, mind you. That's a very hard workout. If you don't want to do the volume stuff, then you could do pinch grip work. You can do all kinds of things. Again, check out my Ultimate Grip Strength Guide. I show you some of the moves, but it doesn't take long. It takes 5 to 10 minutes to train your grip. So would you rather do a mixed grip, expose yourself to all kinds of imbalances and risks, injuries, stuff like that? Or would you rather use the magnificent hook grip, which hurts your thumbs like crazy, is not sustainable, cannot lift maximum amounts of weight, and you can't do shrugs or rows with it, right? I don't really think these options are the best, to be honest with you. I say double overhand with straps, number one way to go. You eliminate every single issue in existence, and like I said, you could just isolate your grip at the end of your workout. It takes 5 to 10 minutes. So those are some of the limitations with double overhand regular, mixed grip, hook grip, etc. And this is why I believe double overhand with straps is a superior way to go, especially if you're at a commercial gym using bad barbells. So that's my advice for you today. Consider double overhand with straps. And with that, I will talk to all you guys next time.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, you can also do the trap bar because the trap bar is neutral grip and it eliminates all the problems altogether. So if you still want to do deadlifts, like regular style, no straps, no hook grip, no mix, do the trap bar deadlift or trap bar rack pull, whatever. And now you can work your grip to a maximum extent without exposing yourself to different risks, okay? And without having to use equipment. So the trap bar would be my next best recommendation if you want to keep it raw, per se. So definitely give it a shot.